In this video, you will learn how to switch between different workflow branches in KNIME Analytics Platform. Let's look into it. In this workflow, we read in order data for 2021 and visualize total revenue per store type in the bar chart. Let's now do the same for the data for 2022. You can see that the total revenue values are significantly lower. That is because in 2022, the price started to be recorded in thousands instead of its absolute values. So, we would need to add a math formula node to multiply the price by 1000. But then the workflow won't show the correct numbers for the previous years anymore. How can you make the workflow work correctly for both datasets, before and after the change? You can create two workflow branches and switch between them with switch nodes. They allow you to activate and deactivate branches depending on the input. KNIME has two types of switch nodes, case and if switches. Essentially, they both switch the workflow branches. The case switch nodes, however, are more flexible since they support different numbers and types of ports. Every switch starts with the switch start node. The switch start node splits a workflow into multiple branches and activates one of them depending on its configuration. The switch block then can be closed with the switch end node. You don't have to use it when you don't need to continue the execution of the workflow. For example, if you switch at the end of your workflow between different visualizations or different writer nodes. However, you need to close the switch block if you want to collect the data from an active branch and continue workflow. Each output port in the switch start node corresponds to one workflow branch. The type of output ports in the switch start node doesn't have to match the type of input ports in the switch end node. Let's now return to our example with case switch nodes added. By default, the case switch nodes don't have input and output ports. If you add the node using the quick node adding panel, the correct ports are used automatically. If you drag and drop the node from the node repository, you can manually add them by hovering over the switch node and clicking the plus button. Since the only difference between the branches in our example is the math formula node, we place the start and end switch nodes around it. The upper branch then is used for the data before 2022, where prices come in absolute values, so no transformation is needed. The bottom branch is used for years starting in 2022, where price transformation is required. In our example, there are only two branches, but if needed, you can add more by clicking the plus button. In the configuration window of the KSwitch start node, you can define which output port should be activated and, hence, which branch should be executed. You can do it manually in the active port drop-down window or by using a flow variable. The ports of the KSwitch start node are denoted by indexes starting from 0 for the most upper port. To control the port activation with a flow variable, it should have an integer value corresponding to the port index. In this example, the branch should be activated depending on the year in the input data table. You can use a table row to variable node to export the year value from the table to a flow variable called year. To create a flow variable that can control the KSwitch start node, you need to convert the year variable into an integer value corresponding to port index. 0 or 1. You can do it with the rule engine variable node. It allows you to create a new flow variable by applying your own rule, or, in other words, logical expression, to the selected variable. In the configuration window, you need to write the rule. If the flow variable year is less than 2022, then the new variable should be equal to 0. For all other cases, the new variable should be equal to 1. You can name the new flow variable, for example, port. Then, in the case switch start node, you can now control the port selection automatically with the newly created integer port variable. Now, when the input data is earlier than 2022, the port variable is 0 and the upper port gets activated. When the data is from 2022 or later, the port variable is 1 and the lower port gets activated. Now, independent of which branch is active, you need to continue the workflow execution with the correct data. The K-switch end node merges the created branches into one single branch and passes the data from the active branch to it. In most cases, you can use the default configuration of the node. If needed, the configuration settings also allow you to deal with multiple active ports. Now, let's execute the whole workflow for data from 2022 and look at the bar chart. The price scale is adjusted and the chart looks correct. If you execute the workflow for the data from 2021, the original price scale is used and the bar chart is correct for this data too. In this video, you have learned how to switch between different workflow branches in KNIME Analytics platform manually and automatically.